Welcome to our instructional video on connecting to a Cloud SQL instance using the Cloud SQL Auth Proxy. Today we'll guide you through this process step by step. To begin, let's create a sample database that we can use for our demonstration. At the same time, we'll enable the Compute Engine API since we're working with a new project. This setup will help us illustrate a common scenario: connecting to a Cloud SQL database from a Compute Engine virtual machine, or VM. Imagine you have a database in Cloud SQL, and you want to connect to it from a Compute Engine VM. This connection can be challenging, especially if the VM is in a different project or network. Traditionally, you might use a networking-based connection, but today we'll explore a more flexible approach using the Cloud SQL Auth Proxy. The Auth Proxy offers several advantages. Instead of relying solely on network configurations, it leverages the Identity and Access Management, or IAM, system. This means that as long as you have a network path, you can use the Auth Proxy as a secure bridge to your Cloud SQL instance. One significant benefit is that you don't need to worry about setting up authorized networks, which can be complex and time-consuming. Let's return to our database setup. We'll select a small, cost-effective database to keep our hourly expenses low. Creating the instance is a quick process that typically takes just a few minutes. While we wait for the instance to be ready, let's discuss an important point. Even though our Cloud SQL instance will have a public IP address, you would usually need to configure authorized networks to permit access. However, by using the Cloud SQL Auth Proxy, we can bypass this requirement. In fact, without setting up authorized networks, the Auth Proxy becomes our only way to connect to the instance, and that's exactly what we're demonstrating today. For our next step, we'll use the Cloud Shell. It's worth noting that the Cloud Shell operates outside of our project's virtual private cloud, or VPC. This means we'll be connecting from an external bash terminal, simulating a real-world scenario where you might connect from outside your Google Cloud environment. Our first task is to ensure we have the Cloud SQL Auth Proxy available. If you're using the Cloud Shell, you're in luck. It comes pre-installed. However, it's important to know how to set it up if you're working in a different environment. Let's briefly review the documentation to understand the installation process. If you need to install the Cloud SQL Auth Proxy manually, you would typically use a curl command to download the library directly from Google. The exact command can be found in the official documentation, which we recommend consulting for the most up-to-date instructions. Now, let's focus on how to connect using the Auth Proxy. We'll start the proxy using a TCP connection type. The command string we'll use allows us to connect from any address to the appropriate MySQL port. We'll need to specify the connection name, which we can obtain from the Cloud SQL console. It's important to understand that this operation will use our logged-in identity to set up the authentication proxy. This authentication aspect is crucial as it ensures a secure connection to our Cloud SQL instance. Let's go ahead and connect. Oh, it seems we've encountered a small hurdle. the system is telling us that we need to enable the Auth Proxy API first. This is a common occurrence when working with new projects or using a service for the first time. Don't worry, we can easily resolve this. We'll quickly enable the Auth Proxy API through the Google Cloud Console. Once that's done, we'll try our connection command again. Great news! After enabling the API and rerunning our command, we're now successfully connected to our Cloud SQL instance through the Auth proxy. To summarize what we've accomplished, we created a Cloud SQL instance, set up the Auth proxy, and established a secure connection without needing to configure complex networking rules. This method allows for flexible and secure database access, especially useful when working across different projects or networks. While we've demonstrated a terminal-based approach, you can also use the Auth proxy Docker container or the native integration and services like Cloud Run. As usual, we'll include the diagram file in the video description for your reuse and revision. If you'd like to support the channel, get a free trial of our new design tool in the description and let us know what you think. We'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions and want to thank you for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.